Good morning, ma'am.
Sports has the power to change the world. Sports has power to inspire the world. Sports are more than just games. Sports are about life, emotions, and passions. A very good morning to Honorable Chief Guest, respected Principal Sister Kavita, teachers, and my dear students. On behalf of entire Divine Child Senior Secondary School, I extend a warm welcome to one and all present here. We are all gathered here today for the celebration of National Sports Day. National Sports Day is celebrated every year on 29th August. This day is also known as Rashtriya Khel Divas. It is the birth anniversary of hockey legend Major Dhyanchand. Today is a moment of pride and glory for all Indians. On this special occasion, our school feels proud to commemorate this day by paying homage to the greatest sportsman of India, Major Dhyanchand, and respect to all greatest sportsmen that our country has produced. Let us unite our minds and souls in the presence of God to seek His abundant blessings. I request Samantha teacher to kindly lead us with a prayer.
God, our Father, we welcome your presence here among us. As we gather together today to celebrate the National Sports Day event, you have created us to strive for the best. Grant to all the athletes, coaches, and fans strength to pursue excellence during every event. We pray for the safety of the athletes all over the world. Protect them from all the injuries and harm. Lord, we also lift up the people of Afghanistan to you right now. We pray that you would take hold of them and help them walk through this fearful time. Protect them under your wing and help them feel the comfort and peace that only comes from your powerful presence. Bless everyone present here and those in their homes that they would experience your all-abounding love and blessings. We make this prayer in your mighty name. Amen.
If one takes a closer look at the alchemy of the achieving person, two distinct virtues pop up, besides perseverance and hard work. These are pioneering spirit and willingness. Our guest of honor, Mr. Vinod Yadav, is a living example of this. With this, I request Bhavya teacher to welcome such sportive personality.
Good morning, everybody. I'm glad to see that everyone is excited for National Sports Day. It is my absolute honor to introduce our chief guest, Mr. Vinod Yadav, the founder and the CMD of Creduc Sporting Excellence and Performance Private Limited, aims at building sports culture in the society. We would like to thank you for accepting our invitation and gracing us with your presence as a chief guest for today's event. Mr. Vinod Yadav's achievement in the field of sports is excellent and your contribution towards raising the bar for future generation. Sir has participated in various state and district level sports tournament. Apart from cricket, he has also participated in baseball and softball tournaments. he has got certification in Australian Strength and Conditioning Association, Health and Fitness Certification from Sports Authority of India, and Yoga Certification from Bangalore. Mr. Vinod Yadav is a respectable personality who is widely known to have put in a lot of efforts in encouraging physical education program and multi-sports program, as well as in the area of fitness and wellness services. He is inspiration to all of us. He has completed bachelor's and master's degree in physical education from University of Mumbai. He was topper in Department of Physical Education from University of Mumbai. He is currently a trainer at Maharashtra Cricket Association for under 23 men's cricket team from past 2 years, and also worked as trainer at Maharashtra Cricket Association for under 16 boys cricket team in 2018. Apart from this, he was trainer at Nasik District Cricket Association from past 5 years, and also attended various workshops. It is a proud privilege to have him with us today. And thank you, sir, for taking that time from your busy schedule to grace this event. We hope that the students are able to seek your guidance and imbibe something from your thoughts. Thank you, sir, for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Bhargava ma'am. Thank you, Divine Child School, for inviting me over on this great occasion. That is National Sports Day, we are celebrating, and it's my honor to be here with you all. I'm so excited to see the kids, you know, rather than, you know, giving some PPT, I would like to, you know, discuss with them. That's the best thing I can do. That this is what I feel, because, you know, the whole past from 2 years, they are like on mobile, you know, just following PPTs. I can understand there are limitations with the teachers as well, but you're also putting a lot of efforts. But yes, I'll try to, you know, not... I don't want to get in long bhashans, but yes, definitely, I'll motivate them and I'll speak to heart out what they want and what, how they should, you know, approach the career in sports and whatever they like in terms of sports. Okay, thank you. Thank you for having me, my sister Kavita Yole ma'am as well. It was great to be part of this school. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. With this, I want to add 2 lines in Hindi. हौसले बुलंद कर रास्तों पर चल दे तुझे तेरा मुकाम मिल जाएगा बढ़कर अकेला तू पहल कर देख कर तुझको काफिला खुद बन जाएगा चैंपियंस aren't made in the gyms चैंपियंस आर मेड फ्रॉम समथिंग दे हैव डीप इनसाइड देम अ डिजायर अ ड्रीम अ विजन नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट सेनेरिटा टीचर टू शेयर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द डे
Significance of National Sports Day. National Sports Day is celebrated on August 29th every year in India. The date 29 August is chosen as it is the birth date of Indian hockey legend Major Dhyanchand. The day is also known as Rashtriya Khel Divas. It was first celebrated in year 2012, and since then it is observed every year. National Sports Day is celebrated as an honor to Major Dhyanchand, whose heroics in hockey has won India several medals at international stage. He is also considered as India's greatest hockey player ever. He also led India to 3 Olympic gold medals in year 1928, 1932, and 1936. In his more than 20 years of long career, the hockey wizard has scored more than 400 goals for India. Major Dhyanchand was awarded India's third highest civilian honor, Padma Bhushan, in 1956 by the Government of India. National Sports Day holds a special place for all sports lovers. It is celebrated to honor the spirit of sportsmanship and spreading this message through various sports. Sports are considered very important for physical and mental development of humans. The person who plays any kind of sports always remains healthy. There are many sporting legends in India, like PT Usha, who is known as Udaan Pari, Sachin Tendulkar, known as Master Blaster, and Major Dhyanchand, who is known as Hockey Wizard. The main reason for celebrating National Sports Day is to highlight and spread awareness about importance of sport and staying fit in daily life. After 2012, when the day was first celebrated in India, the day was used to announce several sports-related schemes, including Khelo India movement, which was announced by the Prime Minister of India in year 2018. On this day, achievers in Indian sports are felicitated. The deserving and successful sportsperson are conferred with Arjun Awards and Khel Ratna Awards in a special ceremony organized in Ashoka Hall, Rashtrapati Bhavan. The sportsperson received the awards from the President of India. The sportsperson from various fields are conferred in this award ceremony. Those who have contributed to Indian sports and have received fame for the country deserve to be honored. We need to recognize and reward sportsperson for their contribution in their respective fields. Schools across the country celebrate their annual Sports Day on August 29. This day helps all aspiring sports person to know about the various advancements in sports and what all our country has achieved in sports. Celebrating National Sports Day provides a chance to encourage all kind of sports person. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher, for an inspirational message. It is rightly said, all work and no play makes a Jack a dull boy. Our school always focus on sports and physical activities, which helps in maintaining the health and improves the decision-making power. In this current circumstances, students, you might not be able to do this in teams, but whatever you can do, which is safe and possible, keep up the good work. It's a great privilege to felicitate our student from grade 9, Manal Mastan, who made us proud by winning a silver medal in Suburban District Kickboxing Championship, which was held on 25th July 2021. The medal reveals the perseverance and the hard work that she has put in. Let's put our hands together and honor our champion. Without much further ado, now I would like to invite our principal to address today's gathering.
Good morning to one and all, respected chief guests of the day, teachers, parents, and my dear students. Today, we celebrate a National Sports Day. The day is celebrated to honor the hockey player Major Dhyanchand Singh, who made India proud by his extraordinary sporting skills. Sports are considered very important for physical and mental development of human being. The person who plays any sports remains always healthy. As it is said, health is wealth. Sports also helps us to develop our personality and to have a better understanding of ourselves. Therefore, my dear students, sports is a very important activity for the students. It's only one activity which can help us to develop multiple qualities like sense of togetherness, leadership skill, physical strength, planning, patriotism, and teamwork. These qualities which will help us to grow in life. National Sports Day is not only a tribute to one greatest in the game, it also reminds us the importance of sports in our life. So today, we have in our midst a great personality, Mr. Vinod Yadav, who will explain to you about health and fitness of lifestyle. Once again, we welcome you, sir, to our Divine Child family. Welcome, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sister. Your thought-provoking address set a perfect platform for our school. Successful people maintain good habits that go hand in hand with success in every area of endeavor, which develops a reputation, The way one works determines the quality and quantity of rewards. Amidst us, we have such great personality today. Yes, I now request our honorable chief guest to please share your experience and knowledge with our students. So,
hello everyone. Thank you, Aarti ma'am, Bhavna ma'am, all the teachers over here, especially the kids who are waiting. I'll just speak, for a couple of minutes on the health part and the fitness part in your lifestyle. But I want you all to speak more, ask your questions, so that I can clear it out. I should know what you are, what you all have in your head. That's the most important thing. This is what I feel. Okay. My first question will be to everyone over here. So to take any profession, let's talk about teaching. The teachers are here. Let's talk about your parents working with some companies or a business or whatever field they have chosen. They are there. But for that, what is the main thing you have to do to take any career or to do anything? The first thing is your health. If your health is not good, how you are going to make it? If your health is not going to, is not good, if your mental health is not good, if your physical health is not good, you're not going to go for any business. The body is not responding, how you're going to perform any act or take decisions. So the first thing is, which is very, very important. Earlier we used to say, roti kapda makan, that's the line in all the films you must have heard, right? Or teacher bhi bolte rahenge. But still, you might have written the answers as well. I used to remember, I have written this answer. So what the basic necessities, but the prime after the corona pandemic, the main thing which now has turned up is your health. If you are healthy, then only other things you can do. Right or wrong, Dean, Vedant, I want you all to speak. Am I right or wrong?
Right, yes, sir.
Right, so
yes, sir.
First thing, you have to be healthy enough.
Yes, right? Sir.
So, Vidhi, am I audible, Vidhi? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
So, that's the first thing you are going to tell your parents as well. Tell your teachers as well. I know that your school is doing good in sports. Bhakti ma'am told me. I had a discussion with her ki how the things go along in your school regarding sports activities. That was good. But tell Bhakti ma'am also, the teachers must be doing yoga to teach you all because they require a lot of patience to deal with the kids, right? I've been in this field for past so many years and I have learned this, that without health, no one can achieve anything. So the first thing will be keeping your health, and how you're going to keep it healthy to yourself is simple. By doing some physical activity, you all know there are a lot of articles, a lot of videos you might be seeing, ki fitness karna hai, healthy rehna hai. But making it into reality, you have to keep practicing. At least minimum 45 minutes to 1 hour. Please tell your parents, you should not interfere when you're doing any workout or playing any sport. At least 1 hour a day. That's the compulsory. And our government has also brought new schemes. There are a lot of things come up to the schools, to the parents, to the teachers. Everyone knows that the government also has taken initiative. And that was just because, a lot of people, our government had introduced Fit India movement, which was a great boom to all the youngsters. Khelo India was there. So bringing all those stuff, why they did it? Because, to make you fit, make you capable to, perform or any actions or activity at any level. So that's the thing. So do fitness at regular intervals. So, or play any sport, but please go and play. That's the key. I'll tell you a research. A research says, I did a small research at my, for fitness centers I have in 3 cities. So the basic thing, during the pandemic, we were training online, or you say, however we got the opportunity, we did that. And there was not a single corona case to the kids. In a family, the parents were having it, but kids were not having that, the COVID situation. But it was not with the kids. So it was very simple. It is very easy, clear, that if you train or if you perform any some sort of activities, physical activity or play any sports, it will definitely boost your immunity. And you can reach to your goals. Okay. So the health, the fitness part, and why I've making it in your lifestyle. I don't want you all to say, you all listen to, sir, or your teachers or your coaches, go for 2 days, full josh mein, then you will play 2 days, 2-3 din karoge, and then after time, we'll do it the day after tomorrow. But don't do that. In this, yes, your continuity is what matters. So that's what, if you bring it, if you want to bring it into your lifestyle, you have to make a continuity. That's the key. To be a sports person or to be a fitness enthusiast, to be a healthy person, you have to bring all these steps in daily routine. And it's very simple. You just play, just train. You might be having a lot of coaches at your schools, or if you're going for any academies or any fitness centers, whatever. But you can ask them, you can ask your teachers always, you know, take their guidance and perform the activities. That's the important thing. And I would request everyone to at least take one sports in your life. Whether you be a champion or not, but it definitely teaches you a lot of things. This will be a game changer for you all in your life. Definitely, because, you know, there are a lot of options. I'll tell you, that's all the thing. But it is nothing like that. That are all myths created by a lot of people, those who are not aware of those things. But I'm making it very clear. If you are taking sports as well, if you are not performing, if you're not going and representing India also, but there are a lot of career opportunities in sports that have come up, and it is paying a lot of in terms of financial terms. I'm talking, you're a little small to understand the financial terms, but still, if you take up a career in sports, you will be paid highly and you can make a great career out of it. I'm telling you, you can make a lot of money, a lot of fame by taking up sports as well. That doesn't mean you won't study. You have to study. You know, that's not the thing. So there are a lot of career opportunities also. If the school wants, I can, you know, sometime come over there, or on virtual, I can talk to the parents as well and with you all well, how you have, you know, a lot of opportunities in the sports coming up. So if you take any sports, there are a lot of options. You have sports management coming up when you grow up. You have, you know, trainers jobs are there. You know, good athlete, good coaches are there, assistant coaches are there, physiotherapist job is there. You know, how to handle a team, how to manage a team. There are around more than 50 to 60 professions, a good profession that can, you know, lead you to success. That's the key. But for that, you have to study as well. So I'll give you 5 things what you have to, you know, after today. I hope that you will try to follow at least all these 5. So the first thing is your health, which we had over. So for health, you have to eat good, you know, do physical activity. So your health, physical health, mental health, then you have to practice your skill. If you're taking any sports, you have to be good in that. Then your diet is very, very important. You have to eat healthy. Pizza, burger, not always, occasionally, because you have got one life, you should eat, but very, very occasionally. You know, my athletes are not advised unless if there is a cheat day. A cheat day is like one day you can eat anything, but not in a huge quantity, but, you know, sometimes it is advisable, but not every time. And lockdown mein toh, we have ate so many of pizzas. Those companies have gone from here to there because of us. But please avoid all the junk food. So the diet is very important. Your rest is also very important. If you're not taking 8 hours of sleep, if you're not resting well, you're not fresh, you're not active, you're not going to perform at any stage. And then your studies. So this you all have to give equal importance. I'm again repeating it, equal importance to your studies, to your physical activity, to your diet, to your health, to your rest. That is all very, very important. So please try to balance it. And this, it will be up to you how you are going to balance it. I don't want you all to tell your parents, please, you know, make a timetable for me. Because I think now we should be self-dependent and we have to find a way how we are going to, you know, tackle all this and club all the stuff and practice it every day. So this is very, very important. Okay. And so I hope this things are very clear to you. Please bring it to your lifestyle. Bringing the lifestyle is every day practicing it. You know, regular following all the schedule of your, these are the 5 things I told you, that will definitely lead to success and be a better person. Okay, and now I want everyone to speak. Baba ka pravachan thoda kam kar deta hu, because I don't want me speaking, rather than I want you all to ask questions. Whatever small doubts you have, please open up and speak. This is the time where teachers, today we have got the opportunity that you will speak more. Teachers are always there. They are explaining you ki kaise karna hai. But I say, since I have been with the same thing, I understand ki how the things have to be taken into the consideration and done. But the teachers are the best ones. If you have any doubt also later on, wherever, please reach to your mentors, to your teachers, because they are the pillars, as you know, because they are the makers of the society. We are not the makers, the teachers are the makers. So please respect them. Ask them many questions. Clear your fitness doubts with your coaches, trainers, academies, your study doubts with them. But if you speak more, so that will be better, because the coming generation needs communication gap. We don't want any communication gap with the teachers and the kids. And preferably I'm very, very friendly with all my trainers, all my participants, or all the students, whoever comes to me. Okay, so let's have a KBC type. Okay, where you can be Amitabh and I can be any common man. Okay, chalo. Let's see who wants to ask questions. Aarti ma'am, you can take anyone. If they have questions, I'm ready to answer them.
So I have questions.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for your guidance and motivation. Surely the students have got enlightened. Thank you for the tips. We teachers also would follow this. Thank you, sir. So I would like to pose some questions which has been put forth by our student.
Okay.
So am I audible?
Yes, sure, ma'am. Go ahead.
So first question is from Sushmita from grade 10. Okay. A question is, sir, during your struggle days, what motivated you and how?
Okay, so the struggle days was not good, belong to a middle class family. I got whatever I wanted, but the main struggle actually I was not that good, to be very frank, during my study days, you know. I was terrible. I used to get passing marks just because I was playing, but my teachers, that's what again I'm telling you, they were the ones who used to push me, okay, you just play well, but we are there with you. They used to help me. That they were the ones who have motivated always. And please, I also request all the students, you know, to put your heart out to your teachers, because they are the one who make you. During my struggle, I struggled when I stopped playing. Then I was very confused that I didn't go at that level, but really I wanted to do something in the field of sports. And then I sat day one down. My parents were up to me, please do MBA. You know, you can good job. But my heart was not telling me to do that. So rather I chose sports as a career to study. So I did bachelor's, master's. Then I'm currently pursuing my PhD as well. And then after that, I did so many of fitness courses, behavior management courses, sports psychology courses. After that, I set up my own company. It's a private limited where we are into all sporting services to the international leading schools all over Maharashtra. We are in 3 cities right now. So there was one day that I was blank and confused, but yes, what I had in my mind that I should give back something.
Are you trying to say appreciation speech? Bola mathe. Society. Abhi mummy badda ne ab tak tak maru bhuli.
Pridhima, mute yourself. Pridhima, mute yourself.
It's okay. So that time I thought ki how I can give back to the society. So that's what made me push that I should do something. I should study, take sports as an education career, and then progress it. So that was a thing. But yes, there were mentors who I needed help. There were my coaches, or there were my teachers. There were some business personalities whom I had a word when I was failing at business, during my business model structure. And then slowly now I can say yes, that slowly by a lot of experience and a lot of struggle, lot of hard work also it goes. So I've reached a good platform now where I can, be available for all the kids in terms of sports services. And that's all the thing. Struggle is there, and please put yourselves in the toughest situation at every stage. If you are 8 years, 5 years, doesn't matter. But I'd request all the kids also to find your place at every difficult situations where you try to, explore yourself and come out of that by your capabilities. Yes, definitely take help of your mentors. That's very important, because they are the ones who will guide you and take you to success.
Thank you, sir. Next question is from grade 7, Saksham. His question is, how will you try to maintain your fitness in lockdown, and how will you try to practice an outdoor sport?
Okay, this question have been coming to my ears from the past 2 years, how everyone has the technology, like we have shifted. So the first thing what I'll suggest is, like, the kids are not been vaccinated. Yes, recently, a couple of days back, we have got that about 12 years can be vaccinated, but it has not started fully in a full-fledged way. But yes, now what children can do, or all the students who are watching this platform, you all can at least do 45 minutes of workout during at your play. You have a lot of videos, you have your coaches. I'm damn sure that school might be taking your PE sessions. In that also, if you practice every day with your coaches, Bhakti ma'am would be there, or there would be many coaches who would be helping the kids in their PE sessions or any fitness sessions. That will definitely help you. If you cannot, you know, progress it, but the main thing what you can do is you can maintain it as of now. So rather than progressing your thing, because we have a barrier, like, you know, the coaches are not physically present in front of you, and then, you know, there are some limitations we're talking out. But yes, what you can do is you can maintain your fitness level. You can maintain your game strategies, like if you're playing any sports, so you can practice your shadow. You can do a shadow practice at your home with proper guidance of your coaches. If they give you programs, follow that. You know, these small things will definitely help you. I can understand that, you know, at home, sometimes it's difficult, you know, to do all those stuff. But yes, we have to find out a way, because, you know, it's this thing has come to all over the world, and we have to fight with the COVID situation. So as of now, during your home, please follow whatever your coaches are telling to you. Just for 45 minutes, half an hour, or, you know, these things. Just remove some time and give time for a fitness level. And please do some shadow practice with your skills. You know, just brush up your skills. If you cannot improve it, but just try to maintain whatever you have got till date, you can maintain it. That's the best thing you can do it. Because, you know, improving it can be one-on-one, because, you know, in online classes, there are a lot of kids. Coaches might find difficult, you know, to correct everyone at the each time going because of time duration, and there are a lot of factors in that. But please maintain it. Talk to your coaches. If they give you programs, follow that. That's the best thing. And segregate your time for everything, your studies, your sports play. And if you get, after the lockdown, if everything is good, please take up sports. And I would request Kavita ma'am, principal also. I know I have heard that the school management is definitely promoting sports, and it will be great if we all are promoted more on a larger scale, because the school name can go more higher if the sports promotion is more. So that's what I feel. And this is the simple thing you can do. There are a lot of apps coming up. I have launched recently a fitness app. You know, my company has come up with a fitness app where you can download it on Play Store and Apple Store. It's by Credac name. If you want, I can, you know, give you the details, but I will forward it to Bhakti ma'am can give you all. You can have a look. It's very simple. There are instructions given. There are videos of it, how you can go do simple things with by using your household items. This is things you can do. But please make sure that you're not skipping it. One day you can have rest in a week, and please follow it. Okay, thank you.
Sir, next we have Vidhi Kotian from grade 9. Her question is, what's the first thought that comes in your mind when you think about sports?
It's the best question, and I've answered it many times. The best, the line which comes is acceptance. Acceptance, I mean, this word will be, how you might be asking, okay, acceptance for what? Acceptance for everything, for winning, for losing, for decision making, you know, at any, whatever sports or whatever career you choose, you need to have acceptance. Because if you know, if you're accepting the things, you're definitely leading ourselves to a positive approach. If you know that you're yourself, that you are struggling at something, or you're weak at some sports, or you're weak at some of the skills, if you accept that, the next second you'll try to improve. So please have acceptance, because the sport says you have to be winner, you have to be loser. You have to be a bad patch, you know, every sports player go through a bad patch. So you need to accept that, and, you know, just keep the process going on, how you will channel yourself, how you will play, follow your basics, you know. Simple is, accept it and follow your process. This will definitely, this word, I think I should tattoo it, because I was, students don't do that, but I feel that if anything comes, this is the best word or best thing can come to a person, that acceptance will definitely lead you to success. I won't promise you can be a good player or anything, but yes, you will definitely improve when you have an acceptance in your life, for sure.
Next question is from Atisha Maheshwari from Grade 5. A question is, what is the one piece of advice you would like to give someone who is deciding to become a sports person?
Okay, so the earlier point I will highlight first, be ready to accept all the things. You know, you might turn up playing a good level or a small level, it doesn't matter. But take decisions wisely and boldly. Put your heart out, listen to your mentor, listen to your parents, and then discuss with them and then go. The piece of advice would be to take up sports. I think you should take it sports as a career, for sure. There are a lot of opportunities waiting for the kids, for the coming generations, because in next coming 10 years, India is booming in sports field at various stages. Talk about sports, taking any sports, talk about management, sports management, talk about health sector in that. Health is, connected with the fitness part, your sports part, healthy lifestyle part. So please take up sports and play any sport if whatever you feel, but please try. Because you never know, there can be one time that you will get a click and you can reach up to the highest level. You know, but please take up sports and follow your process. You know, eat well, rest well, train well, do your physical activities, study well, bring everything and enjoy your life, explore your life. Let's decide and fix up your goal where you have to reach and just try to give you 100%. Whether you reach or not, that's a different thing. But yes, putting 110% efforts, that's in your hand. Please do that.
Next, we have Yogita from grade 8. Her question is, at any point of time, did you ever think of doing something other than cricket? If yes, what would it be and why?
So, as I told earlier also, okay, I was very confused. My parents were up to, please do this MBA, go for this IPS. I was like, I was not ready to take, because I had chosen career initially as cricket as a career. Then I got to know that there were some limitations in me. I couldn't perform that well, to be very honest. Then I thought of why not to make it as a career in terms of education field. So I got into the university, then I topped over there. There are 8 to 9, 10 courses which I did on health sector, fitness sector, you know, mental part, these things. There were times that I struggled a lot, but yes, definitely I was very, very keen to give back something to the society. Again, I thought that I would go on my process, which I told earlier, that following the process was my key. Whatever happens was the later on. There will be your relatives telling you, kya kar rahe ho, sportsman aisa kuch nahi hai. But I was least interested. Now I can surely say that in 4 years, we have reached in 3 cities. My organization or my company has reached in 3 cities, Mumbai, Pune, Nasi. We have tied up with 14 leading tribal schools all over Maharashtra. Then I've got a fitness app. I've got my fitness centers. I've got my own merchandise products, fitness products launching on my app. There are a lot of things I did, and there are a lot of things to be done again for the society in terms of sports and fitness. So, but pushing myself and following the process was the key. There are many times I was failing. I was failing miserably, funds problem, other problem, but still somehow, following the process helped me to manage my stuff. So please, children, don't be disheartened with small losses or, if you don't perform good in studies as well or your sports part, keep working hard and keep the process going. That's the key.
Last question from Reed Kaur, grade 6. Her query is, due to pandemic, kids are at home most of the time and there is literally no outdoor play for them. So how can they stay fit physically staying at home?
Okay, so simple tips though, teachers might have given you, whatever activities have been told to you in your PE sessions or your sports sessions, please do that. The first thing, please do that. Enjoy that to the fullest. Then the second thing, you can read some of the articles which are coming up on sports or read something so that you keep yourself busy, because reading also can give you, and there are a lot of apps have come up that gives you exposure to sports. Please do play or Google it or download the apps. There are available for different sports, how you can perform at home as well. If you have your coaches, if the school is allowing them to practice with them, and for extra, if you want to do, you can download. There are many apps in the Play Store you can get, where you can put a particular sports name and you can download it and you can get the things, read those things, watch some sports videos, watch some motivational videos, which will help you. Please avoid playing games for a lot of times. You know, for completely sitting hours and playing on the, just working out your fingers. So finger strength will increase, but mind will be blocked. So I am not telling you, please avoid those things. That is a part of a life, but don't give too much importance to the mobile games. Play for 10, 15 minutes. It's okay. But, you know, sitting for a longer duration on these mobiles will not help it. Rather than use it like wisely, download. There are many apps, as I told you. Watch. There are apps for reading as well. You can go through sports articles, what the players are following. You can read into those things. These things will keep you engaged and keep you motivated, because if you're reading good things, definitely is going into your mind. And this is the best thing how you can do, sit to your home and motivate yourself. And I don't want the kids to motivate yourself, but motivate to your parents as well. That I'm good, don't worry. And I want you also to be stress-free. We will definitely find out a way, and we'll definitely find this COVID situation. And I think it will be in coming days, there will be end to these things. And if you are fit, if you are practicing all the healthy routine and fitness regime, we will definitely beat this corona in coming times. But read, watch the videos of different sports personalities, different sports videos, healthy videos. Please do that. And also perform also practice by looking at the different apps, which I can put it into the school. I have the links. I can suggest to the school. If the school wants me to do that, I can definitely do it. I can pass it to the schools. Please follow that. But keep yourself engaged in good things. That's the key, which you can do the least as of now. Eat healthy stuff. Enjoy, you know, do that.
Thank you very much, sir, for a wonderful informative session. This session would inspire our students to adapt sports as part of their daily lives and contribute towards a healthier India. I hope our sports enthusiasts are enlightened through this session. Right? Yes, student. Can anyone say it?
Right. Sriram.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, yes. Mute now. Mute. Okay. I can see the excitement. As we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. Requesting Bhakti teacher to express the words of gratitude.
Good morning, respected principal, sister Kavita, teachers, and my dear students. On behalf of Divine Child Senior Secondary School, CBSE, I take this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks to our guest for today, Mr. Vinod Yadav, founder and managing director of Creduc Sporting Excellence and Performance Private Limited, for sparing some time out of his busy schedule to address our student on fitness and lifestyle. I take this opportunity to thank Principal Sister Kavita for her support and confidence in us. My deep sense of appreciation and thanks to all the teachers and participants who joined us live and attended this session with enthusiasm and made it a successful event. Wishing all of you a very happy National Sports Day and big salute to the legend Major Dhyanchand. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Aarti ma'am. Thank you, all the teachers and the principal of Divine Child Yogita ma'am, Kavita ma'am, for inviting me and having me over here. It was great interacting with the kids and to the school. It will be always my pleasure. And if the school has anything regarding any sports services or sports things or any doubt regarding those things, please, you can anytime turn up to me. If I have something, definitely I can provide you with all the stuff, whatever the school needs with me. Thank you so much for having me. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, once again. With this, I want to add two lines. Sports is like you win, you lose. But the most important thing is the process in which you dissolve. On this day, let's pledge that we all should be connected to the sports one way or the other. Yun hi nahi milti rahi ko manzil, ek junoon sa dil mein jagana hota hai. Poocha chidiya se, kaise bana aashiyana, boli, bharni padti hai udaan baar baar, tinka tinka uthana hota hai. With this, we have come to the end of our program. Let us all stand for national song. Requesting Bhakti teacher to kindly share the song.
Vande Mataram, Sujalam Sufalam, Malayaja Sheetalam, Sasya Shyamalam Mataram, Vande Mataram, Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakitayamini, Pullakusumita ద్రుమదళ శోభినీ సుహాసినీ సుమధుర భాషిణీ సుఖదాంబరదాం మాతరం వందే మాతరం వందే మాతరం.
Thank you everyone for joining this event. Bhakti teacher, they can disperse. You all can disperse now.
Yeah, just 1 minute, take a screenshot.